when you become an astrologer, see why you are with me. I will cut this part out, put it on YouTube as well. Right? Why? See, the process of learning astrology, and I will explain it to you. Why you should come to a teacher, point one. When you should come to a teacher, point two. First of all, never come to a teacher, not this word, it isn't. You want to come to a teacher, why? What is the importance of a teacher? To get thorough with the subject, point one. To get the guidance, point two. If you don't come to a teacher, if you just start learning from YouTube videos or books or anything, you will have n number of confusions, right? Which Ayanamsha to use, which house calculation to use, whether I should do KP astrology, Nadi astrology, Gemini astrology, Bhrigu astrology, XYZ astrology, what to do. There will be a whole lot of confusion. To clear that confusion, it will take you years. Because today you will decide Lahiri is best because many people use Lahiri. Then after 5 months, 1 year, you will come across one astrologer who is very good in predicting, but he is using new KP Ayanamsha. Then you will start using new KP Ayanamsha. Then after 6 months, you will come to find me. You will be like, this person uses Chandra Hari and he says that Chandra Hari is very accurate. Getting my point or not? Right? After some time, you come to find me. Okay, point one. Point two. You come to astrology, you know, okay, there is a natal chart. And this is read in this particular way. What is Navamsha? How to use Navamsha? Whether there is a Navamsha or not? How many types of Dasha are there? Dasha are not there? These are multiple things, right? So you are a student, you don't know what is there. Getting my point? The teacher is already learned. He knows. So first of all, first process is joining someone, right? So when I join someone who is practicing astrology before me, I get four things. I know what is there. Okay. You know what is Muhurta, what yogas are used in Muhurta, what is Prashna, different systems of astrology, right? You don't know about it. The teacher will know about it. He will let you know about it, point one. Second thing is, teacher will give you a base. Teacher will give you a base. See, there is a small or very big, large, huge difference between a good teacher and a bad teacher, point one. Between a book and a teacher, point two. And it is the same difference. You know what? When you read a book or when you go to a bad teacher, they will open up a chart, both the book and the bad teacher, and they'll tell you that, see, Saturn is in the fourth house. The dasha of the Saturn is happening. This happened. Okay. That will never make you do a prediction. Let me be very honest with you. What is the approach? If a chart comes to me, I know that this person got married in this year. I open dasha, antar dasha, I see it is this dasha, that dasha. I write in the book, okay, okay. This happened, that happened. You read the book, you become extremely delighted. But when you will want to see the horoscope, you will get no result at all, I guarantee you. You will get to see no result at all. So, what a good guru and what a good book does to you? What book cannot do and what a good guru can do? When a horoscope comes to me, how I start analyzing it? What is my modus operandi when I don't know the event? The person will never ask me, sir, what happened in 2016? Or the person will never give me money to ask, sir, you tell me why my marriage broke. And even if they ask, they will want a psychological answer, not an astrological answer at any given point of time. Right? So a good teacher will, like what I do, I open a chart, I never prepare examples beforehand, I take it in front of you. And explain in front of you how the rules and the techniques that we do. Right? You can never read a book where the author will explain that, okay, this chart comes to me. I see it using this formula. It will never be told. Right? You should be joining a teacher for three reasons. Okay. First of all, to get thorough with the complete subject so that you know what you need to know and you don't know what you don't need to know. In normal world, you will know everything. Then to find out which thing is not useful, which thing I should discard, it will take you long time. So 5 years you spend in learning, 5 years you spend in unlearning, 10 years it will take. And if you are doing consultation that 10 year, I feel very bad for the person who took consultation in this first year from you. Right. So this first thing will go, point one. Secondly, I use Chandrahari Ayanamsha. You know my techniques, right? So you don't have to care about whether you use Lahiri Ayanamsha or what. You are pretty sure that this person is using Chandrahari Ayanamsha. This person uses Chandrahari Ayanamsha, makes prediction based on Chandrahari Ayanamsha. Whatever techniques I have learned from him works only in Chandrahari Ayanamsha. Hence, no confusion. KP New, KP Old, Fagan Bradley, L. Debran, Jagannath, Racine, Lahiri, True Lahiri, Pushy Paksha, this Paksha, that Paksha, no confusion. Simple. Right? Because otherwise, you read books of Mr. K. N. Rao, he will say Lahiri. You use books of Sanjay Rath, he will say True Lahiri. You read books of Narasimha Rao, he will say Pushy Paksha. You read book of B.V. Raman, he will say B.V. Raman Ayanamsha. What you will use me? Neither B.V. Raman will tell you how I see a horoscope, neither K. N. Rao will tell you. About others, I don't want to talk because I'm pretty sure these two people will not reply. I don't want to be in argument and debate on that. So these are the two important things, right, that you get from a person, that you get from a teacher. Follow with the subject, will get a base, and you will know the techniques, right? How do I see the chart? This thing, believe me, even if I write a book tomorrow, I cannot write this thing in a book. Let me be very honest with you. Because speaking for 1 hour and writing for 100 pages is altogether different thing. You believe it? Yes, you do. You will. If someone is drunk and talking to you, he can spill some secrets. But if someone is drunk and writing a book, even in that case, he will not spill a secret. Because you know what he's writing? The sentence formation will be in head before. Getting my point? That's the thing. But to become an astrologer, and I will tell you, this is the way. And to use optimum of a teacher like me, two things are important. First of all, you apply the technique and tell me where it is not working. Because that way you will know the actual methodology. Only when Sutapaji said to me today that, sir, I have a chart and there's a job problem. Then I came to tell you the strength formula, right? Discussed for the first time. Because then just it came to my mind that if I have to see a chart using Gemini astrology, I will not use this strength. I will use this particular strength. Getting my point? This idea came to my mind. Only because today I set to take the practice class, I decided that, okay, I should give them a synopsis of all the 3-4 techniques that we have learned so far. Getting my point? If I only keep on teaching you formulas, Jupiter in 11th from Arud Lagna, person will earn through income tax. Sun in 11th from Arud Lagna, person will earn from government job. I will not be able to tell you this particular stuff, right? So first thing is you apply and you discuss the problem with me. Only then you will be able to apply it next time. You tell me that, sir, you taught this particular technique. I see this chart, this technique failed. Either there can be a glitch in your understanding that I will, okay, that I will, like, you know, rectify it. Or there is something left that either I forgot to tell you or you forgot to listen or note down well. In that scenario, I will tell it again. It will give you power. Getting my point? Only in that case, because, see, I will be very honest with you. You take a course, learn with me for 24 classes. You don't practice it. You don't ask a question. After the 24 classes, my friend, you have wasted your money successfully. Better than this, gift me those money. Gift me that money. I will send you good morning message with Sai Baba photo every day. Good morning. It's better. And I will also talk to you when you're drunk. Okay. Yes. Jokes apart. Right. So that is the optimum use, best use. It doesn't matter you want to become an astrologer or not. That is altogether a different scenario. You don't want to practice astrology. Okay. But at least at the end of the day, you don't want to become a driver. That is okay. But if you purchase a car, at least drive it for once. Otherwise, hire a taxi service. This point one, that will make you utilize what you are learning. But how to become an astrologer? To become an astrologer, I will tell you very, very frank thing. One person, suppose X, Mr. X in 1930, wrote a book in astrology, right? He wrote wrong things. No, he wrote truth. I'll tell you very simple analogy. I will give you. I'm wasting your time. I know, but I will waste. Because understanding is important. Because techniques, you go to my YouTube channel, you see all the courses that you have. I have given ample of techniques. And I'm pretty sure out of those ample of techniques, you cannot even use one. Because understanding, my friend. So, point. I am asking you a pretty simple thing. K.S. Krishnamurti have written one particular technique. Okay? He used it. He was very happy. He thought that I should publish a book over it. He published it. Ken Rao wrote a technique. He published a book. People use it. Fine. Then when this person have already wrote a book, why should I write a book? Or why someone else wrote a book? When Varahamihir wrote a book, my friend. When Varahamihir wrote a book, then why Jatak Parjat was written? Why Saravali was written? Why? Because everyone have a particular style. What? Everyone have a particular style. One astrologer to time events will use Vimshottri Dasha. Only Vimshottri Dasha, right? There will be some people like me. They will use 10 dashas. Right? There will be two people. One who will use all the 10 dasha. One who will use one out of that 10 dasha. There will be third person who will use one Vimshottri Dasha, one Charadasha, one Sudarshan Chakra Dasha. There will be one who will only use Sudarshan Chakra Dasha and Charadasha. One will be who will only use Vimshottri Dasha and Sudarshan Chakra Dasha. Getting my point? One will not use any of them. He will only use transit. Western astrologer will only use progression. Some of them will only use primary progression. Some of them will only use secondary progression. Some of them will use both. Getting my point? So what is there? There are a whole lot of tools. You have six type of knives in your kitchen. You choose the apt knife to cut that particular thing. Getting my point? You choose the apt knife. Whatever is suitable. So every astrologer have a particular set of technique that they use. Right? And getting through it is important. Getting through it is compulsory. You should join a teacher only for this particular reason. Because only in that case, you will know everything that he uses. If he's a good teacher, he will tell you everything that he does. See, bad teacher will never tell you the truth. Bad teacher will be like, I made this prediction, I made that prediction, but you will find this person doesn't take consultation. When you don't take consultation, how you make prediction, you tell me. When you don't take consultation, how you make prediction? You don't make. Simple thing. However, not coming to that particular point, the controversial thing. Coming to my point, what I want to discuss. This is what a teacher gives you, right? This is what I am giving you, how to see a chart, all the... How I do it. You can argue with me, sir. I use KP Astrology, I get very good results. Yeah, you may get it. I don't get. As simple as that, right? Someone is saying to me, sir, I like to live in Mussoorie. My friend, I don't like to live in Mussoorie. Simple. If you like to live in Mussoorie, is it compulsory that I should also like to live in Mussoorie? No. Zabardasti hai kya? Nahi bhai. So when you join me, you get to know all the things that I have found working, and I don't limit you to use other things. As my student, if you find that KP is working well for you, no problem, use it. I don't take Ashwini loaded by Ketu, that's fine. If you think that Ashwini loaded by Ketu works for you, do it. I don't take it because of scholarly reasons, because of multiple reasons, but if it works for you, this is very fine, well, brilliant. Getting my point? So, for this particular reason, it's essential to join a teacher, and only for this particular reason, it is very important to practice yourself. You may find that transit works better. Please do. I have a tendency of taking 10 dashas, Vimshottari, Shodashottari, Dwadashottari, Shatabdika, Chaturashiti Sama, Dvisaptati Sama, Shashti Haini, and Satrimshat Sama Dasha. I use one of these dasha. One of Kalchakra Dasha, Yogini Dasha, Buddhigati Dasha, or Saptarshi Nakshatra Dasha. वन ऑफ चर दशाल, वन ऑफ जैमिनी दशास एंड वन ऑफ मिसलेनियस दशास, फोर ऑफ दीज. एंड आई विल फर्स्ट स्टार्ट टाइमिंग इवेंट यूजिंग जैमिनी दशा, देन विल क्रॉस चेक इट यूजिंग नक्षत्र दशा, then we'll cross check it using two other dashas. I am using four set of dashas, and any event that will be indicated by more than two factors, I will say it will happen. That is my approach. You may take it as dasha plus transit. Nadi astrologer will take it as transit plus progression. Getting my point? KP people will take it as dasha plus transit, but some KP people, Nadi people, will take KP plus progression. Getting my point? Everyone have their own approach. In my consultation, sometime I will take dasha plus annual horoscope. There is something known as annual horoscope, right? You know, or you may not know. I will let you know. Not an issue. You have a good teacher, be sure, right? So sometime what you do, dasha plus annual chart. Sometime what I do, chart plus prashna. I saw the chart. I'm like, okay, you will get a job. The person is like, when I will get a job, I make a prashna. You will job in this year only. If prashna have no combination, then next year there can be a chance. It will take some time. Depends on what set of permutation and combination I want you to write, custom made. So until and unless you practice the things, whether I'm teaching it in the course or free on YouTube, doesn't matter. Until and unless you practice it. Until and unless you use it. Don't expect return. You plant a mango tree, don't give him water, you expect mango. Don't expect. Mango will not come. Pretty simple point. And you have a whole lot of time. The recordings are available for a lifetime. My support is there for a lifetime, right? Always there. That is what I do. Getting my point? So, but start it. I'll tell you, there are n number of professions. If I start making a list of professions that I know, I will end up making a list of 400 professions, I think. Do you think that I can make a list of plenary combinations for this 400 combination and can give you? No. And not every profession is prevalent in every space, every time. In India, there is a profession named astrologer. Do you think there is a profession named astrologer in Iran? No. There is no profession named astrologer in Iran. In Saudi Arabia, there is no profession where someone will sell you havan for puja, ghee for puja. In Saudi Arabia, no one is doing puja with ghee. So that depends on area to area, right? If you are giving consultation to a Bangalorean, it is very probable that this person will be in IT. But at the same point of time, you know, for a Bangalorean person, when I will see Mercury or Venus, I will say IT. But for a person from Bihar, Jharkhand, UP, when I will see Mercury and Venus, I will say government job. The area, you know, getting what? The area will change the signification. For the Bangalore person to be in government job, I will want Jupiter and Sun. And for the person from Bihar to be in a computer job, I will want Saturn and Rahu. Significations will change as per the area. Demographics, what maximum people want. So you have to do it. So you utilize it, you have to do it. That's why I am very mean on taking the practice things. Two charts you can take. Take the chart of your husband and the friend of your child. Take the chart of your husband or husband's sister or husband's or sister's husband. Only two charts you can take. You take the chart of yourself and your closest friend. Doing something. Even if they are not doing anything, you check in the chart why they are not doing anything. Getting my point? When I take you, take a chart for marriage. Don't only take chart of people who are married. Take the chart of those who are not married and see why they are not married. That is also a question. Why not? Everyone gets married. That is the way to use it. That is the way to use it. And I took time out to explain it because I think it is necessary. Right? I think it is pretty necessary to tell this particular point. Because I am here with a very simple motive I have. To see you grow. To see you learn something. To get you ROI. You search what is ROI? Return on investment. That is what I want. Otherwise, if I wanted to make money, you must have some predictions for May. Month for 12 ascendants. मंगल दोष का निराकरण कैसे करें? काल सिर्फ दोष की शांति के 5 अजोग नुस्खे मेरे पूरे चैनल पे नहीं है, ना हिंदी में, ना इंग्लिश में, ना किसी अन्य भाषा में, दूसरी तरह में जाती नहीं है. That is the thing. I'm pretty sure that you people are, you know, got it? Do it. There is no compulsion. Do it at your pace. Easy, very easy. But at least do. Very simple thing. Before you start your day, any day, before you start your day, make a horoscope. When you wake up, make a chart. Or when you think that I have to go to restaurant, make a chart. Take a screenshot. Save it in the mobile. When you come from the restaurant, make a note. Food was good. Okay. Second house, this planet. Second house, Saturn. I don't enjoy the food. This person called me, I have to go out and talk to him. When I came, food became cold. No enjoyment. Getting my point? And not necessarily you sit with a chart, but use it. Use it some place, other place. Go ahead. Right? Any question, confusion, clarification?
Sir, 2 questions. Sir, you said that in Gemini, Rashi is very important. So if Jupiter is there, it will say denote a lot of jobs. How about when it is in, say, in this case, it is in Scorpio. So wo kaise you decide karte? Pehla question. Aur dusra question. Aapne hamesha kaha hai ki astrology should be followed. Hum astrology follow karke jo optimum ya maximum results hum planet se pa sakte hai, wo pa sakte hai.
Yes.
पर सब लोग तो कोई एस्ट्रोलॉजी फॉलो नहीं करता ना. जैसे मेरे केस के अंदर बाय चांस जुपिटर वाला मैंने प्रोफेशन कर लिया, पर कोई ऐसा शिवाजी भी होगा कि वो ऐसा बोलेगा कि नहीं मुझे अपने हिसाब से ही करना है, मतलब वो प्लैनेट्स फॉलो नहीं करता, तो वो कैसे देखेंगे चार्ट में? जैसे आप कई बार बोलते हो कि भाई इसका ग्रह ऐसा बता रहे कि इसको बैंकिंग में जाना चाहिए, पर भाई साहब कर रहे कुछ मेडिकल के बारे में, तो वो कैसे मालूम है?
Yes, important question. Very important question. That's why I say Chintanji always thinks. Chintan means Chinta. Yes. And Chinta is, you know, I always say in Bengali, when you contemplate on something, it will be told Chinta. Very good question. 2 questions, very good. To answer question number 1, this is the particular reason that I teach so much on Rashis. Okay. I'll give you answer. I will give you answer, easy answer, but I will make it complex. Don't worry. Habit. Easy answer is Jupiter in different signs will give different result. Yes. That depends on the nature of sign. Yes. 2 things. For an example, I am taking Jupiter in the 12 signs. Okay. 12 signs Jupiter and what type of differences it can make. Aries. And I will categorize it. Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. These 3 are fire signs. These 3 are fire signs. F-I-R-E. Fire signs, right? So what is Jupiter with fire? What Jupiter have to do with fire? Batao. When it is sun plus fire, it is the fire to rule. When it is moon plus fire, it is the fire to dominate. When it is Mars plus fire, it is the fire of aggression. When it is Mercury plus fire, it is the fire of writing, reading, producing content. When it is Venus plus fire, it is sexual fire. When it is Saturn plus fire, it is a machine. When it is a Rahu plus fire, it is a dacoit. When it is a Saturn plus fire, it is a rebel. But what is Jupiter plus fire? बताओ
जुपिटर
यज्ञ इत्यादि द फायर ऑफ धर्म इज व्हाट जुपिटर इज सपोज टू इंडिकेट इन 159 एरीज लियो सजिटेरियस वन थिंग इफ यू वांट टू डू एनीथिंग इन एस्ट्रोलॉजी डोंट से 159 एरीज लियो सजिटेरियस 159 आर हाउसेस नॉट राशि राशि इज एरीज लियो सजिटेरियस डोंट कंफ्यूज सर जुपिटर इन वन हाउस की वन राशि मेक इट वेरी क्लियर द मोर यू से एरीज बेटर इट विल बिकम ओके In 159, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, Jupiter will be fiery. There is the fire of Jupiter. What type of? So in the Aries sign, it is a movable fire. Okay. In Aries sign, it is movable fire. In Leo sign, it is a fixed fire. In Sagittarius sign, it is a dual fire. What is a movable fire? This person really works with the fire of the temple. Okay. This person really works with the fire of temple. This person is really puja, path, etc. This person is really into worshipping, etc. Is what we are supposed to say, right? I will give you one beautiful example. This is the person who does every puja for me. This is my Panditji. He does every puja for me, whatever puja this person does. He's doing pujas for me since last 5 years. Best results. Jupiter in Aries. His father was a Purohit. His grandfather was a Purohit. His grandfather's father was a Purohit. His grandfather's grandfather was a Purohit. Everyone has been a Purohit, family, in the lineage. Getting my point? Okay. Got it. Now coming to Leo. Leo is fire and fixed. Now he will not burn fire every time. He will not be a Pandit. Jupiter in Leo is a fixed fire. Someone who is Dharmopdeshak. Someone who is Dharma Upadeshak, someone who talks about Dharma. Getting my point, holding the fire of Jupiter. Do you get my point? Holding the dharma of fire. Sorry, stagnate.
Spiritual gurus can be.
Yeah, gurus, intellectual gurus, generally. But along with this, let me tell you. A person appointed in a company to make sure that the rules and regulations are being followed by every employee. Jupiter and Leo. I think there is some position like that, right? You appoint a person.
HR people.
Generally HR. HR, you know, who makes it sure?
Yes.
That this person is coming late in office, going early, and his sales reports are not very convincing. So they will tell you, you meet in office. And HR person is highly abused. Right? Then you go to Gemini, Sagittarius. Sagittarius is a dual sign, both the duties. To create the dharma, puja path, etc. Plus sustenance of dharma as well. Right. I'll show you example. Even chart I am asking for, I am not getting it. Oh, this one chart if I get. Here are the details. Just a second. The thing that I am teaching is pretty important. very, very important. I will present you a small study of few religious gurus. This is the chart of Sri Sri Ravi Shankar. Jupiter in Capricorn, but Dingvalim. It is a water sign, movable sign. Water, movable. The ideas are movable, not rigid, not fixed. It is not like only if you are Brahmachari, you enter. If you are not Brahmachari, go. No. Getting my point? Simple, straight. And it is into a water sign. Water sign does indicate spirituality more than dharma. Right? So have you seen him promoting Vedic Yagya? No. You will see him promoting Sudarshan Kriya. Not Yagya. Will not see. Right? This is the horoscope of Sri Ramana Maharshi. Jupiter in Aquarius, fixed sign. If you are a husband and wife, then you cannot remain in the same room in Ramana Ashram even today. Long after Ramana have already died. Fixed sign Jupiter, right? And that Jupiter is in the sign of Aquarius. That is an intellectual sign. That is an airy sign, intellectual sign. Ramana Maharshi neither promoted any meditation technique nor promoted puja. He promoted self-inquiry. Who am I? Right? This is what he does. Then comes Ramakrishna Paramahansa, Jupiter in a dual sign. That is an airy sign. Once again, he was intellectual. Right? He neither promoted a particular meditation technique nor he promoted how to do yagya and puja part. But he was a dual person. He gave Ramakrishna mission, monks are sannyasis, brahmacharis. But he also gave advice for spiritual householders. Right? He also gave advice to householders. He also made sannyasis. He gave it for both. He said, as many religions, as many paths. Yato mat tato pad, right? He said that from every religion, you can have God realization. He was not strict like Raman, that you do self-inquiry only. You ask Raman, what is Guru? Raman will say you, who is a bigger Guru than self? Raman, everything is on self, right? Fixed sign. Only this, only this, only this. Rigid. This guy is not rigid. This guy is okay. For those who are married, after producing one child, they should remain as friends. Is what Ramakrishna will say. And at the same time, he will say that you should not touch woman and gold. For sannyasi, don't touch woman and gold. For householder, after one child, you should remain as husband and wife. So don't keep on producing 12, 13 children. Getting my point? This is what is does. Like, you know, like Sadhguru Jaggi Vasudevji. Jupiter is an earthly sign and a dual sign. You know what earthly signs are, right? 2, 6, 10. You know the theme of earthly sign, right? That is once again duality. So the Linga Bhairavi, Adi Yogi, going to temple, meditation techniques as well, added to that philosophy also. There is philosophy as well. There is spirituality as well. Like going to temple, the orthodox method of worship also, and this thing also. Getting my point? Both the things are there. So this is what will make a difference. Jupiter in earthly signs. What will earth indicate? That depends on 2, 6, 10. The second, sixth, and 10,000. And that is on earth. That is earth. So what are the qualities of earth? Jupiter in 3, 7, 11. These are the airy signs. What is the quality of air? Jupiter in 4, 8, 12 house. What is the quality of water signs? I have already taught it before, the quality of signs. Even on YouTube, I have many free videos, but don't tell me, sir, in which video you have told. because I will take my half an hour out to research which video I told it, and will give it to you. You will watch the video. What you will give me in return? Nothing. So better, right? So don't ask me this particular thing, sir. Give me that video. But I am telling you that there is one such video out there where I have talked about the how the elements work. Like this, there are multiple things for a Rashi, and you are supposed to take everything into consideration. For an example, this question comes from Chintanji. Let's welcome Chintanji. In the horoscope, if you see, we are considering Jupiter, right? Jupiter as the planet indicating profession. That is in a fixed sign, watery sign, natural 8th house, lotted by Mars. Okay. What fixed sign will indicate? Some sitting job. Chintanji, you are into insurance sector, but do you go door to door to sell insurance?
Loan karta hu, main hi jata hu. Mere paas aata hai.
Yes. The case comes to you. You don't go because it is a fixed sign, not a movable sign. Getting my point? It is fixed. People come. You don't go. One thing clear. Whatever job it is, the person will be sitting at a place. People come to him. Right? Let's go further. It is a watery sign. So things are related to emotion. Water is emotion. So you give every type of loan, Chintanji, or one particular type of?
Home loans.
Home loans. What is home? 4812 by the way, but still, what is home? Home is an emotion. By anyone living on the road is not coming to Chintanji. How he will give money? Getting my point? Someone who is already living somewhere and wants to have a home, emotion, he is coming to him. So it is sitting at a place. Leo is also sitting. Scorpio is also sitting. Aquarius is also sitting. And Taurus is also sitting. Taurus is sitting and is just focused on money. Leo is sitting, just focused on work. Scorpio is sitting with emotions. Aquarius is a sitting intellectual. There is a difference. Do you understand me? And it is the natural 8th house. 3, 6, 8, 10 houses indicates loans itself, right? And that is lauded by Mars. Mars is also the significator of the 8th house. Sorry, Mars is also significator of the loans, etc. Getting my point or not? So yes, yes. Jupiter as the indicator of profession can be in any sign or any Navamsha, depending on whether you are using the technique on sign or Navamsha, right? And based on the characteristics of the sign where it is placed, you decide what it is going to do. That's why there is a whole lot of free classes on YouTube. I taught Rashis. I don't think I taught Rashis so in depth. I think by now I have covered some 50 hours of Rashis only. Rashi, 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 day and night, Rashi, Rashi. Why? Because it is pretty essential. It is pretty essential. I have Venus in 12th house. You have Venus in 12th house. I have Venus in 12th house Capricorn. You have Venus in 12th house Scorpio. Is there no difference? There is. Venus in Capricorn, Earth Rashi, I will look at stability in a relationship. Venus in Scorpio, he was in tough time. Lady supported him. He got married. Once again, he started having tough time. Now his wife haven't supported him. Some other lady supported him. Some employee in office, he fell in love with the employee. Water sign? Earth sign, no. Fix it. Once done, then the Earth sign, no. Getting my point? Venus in the earth sign, for them, good relationship is equal to money. Jupiter in water sign, good relationship is equal to emotional attachment. Sorry, Venus. Venus in the earth sign, good relationship is equal to money. Paisa hai to hai. Venus in water sign, good relationship is equal to emotional attachment. अगर तुम उससे अटैच्ड ही नहीं हो तो प्यार थोड़ी ना करते हो. Venus in the air sign, if the person is not intellectual, काम वाले से शादी कर लेगा क्या आदमी? भाई आपका जितना दिमाग है सामने वाले को भी दो. अपने पति को बोला कि भाई ये चेक भर के बैंक में डाल दो, उसने लिखा FOR 1000 rupees. FOR 1000 rupees. You are you. Venus in fire sign, dharma matters. He is ugly, not rich, doesn't love me, no problem, but he should be faithful. Even if we go to market and he looks at some other lady, char din chandni ke fir kali andheri ra. That is the difference between Venus. You can have Venus in same house, that's not an issue. This is important, right, Chintanji? Point one answered.
Ji sir.
What was point two? I forgot. Point two kya tha bhai? Haan. Follow nahi karta tha. If someone is not following astrology, the three things are there. First of all, person will be atheist. Atheist, there are multiple combinations, more than three malefics, three or more than three malefics in Kendra. You give him the best advice in mind, he will say, I don't believe in astrology. Malefics in the 12th house generally. Malefic in the 12th house, despite being an astrologer himself, he will do no remedy, etc. for himself. He will be like, that's fine. Whatever is supposed to happen will happen. Everything is predestined. Malefic in the 12th house. Right? Bad 9th house. You are not supposed to get fortunate. So no matter whatever one will say. That is basic chart-based combination, right? Someone have a combination for being atheist, not believing in astrology, not believing in God. More than three malefics in Kendra, malefics in the 12th house, 9th lord week. Are few of the combinations. Another thing is time based. Vinashakale Viprit Buddhi. So you are going through dasha of a compassed planet. So your wife is telling that I think you should take some money, and because you left your job, I think you should take some money from me and start a shop. Maybe it will help us. Tu mereko kya dengi? Tu batayi mereko. Hey, what should I do? You will tell me. Should I take money from a woman? Vinash kare. Now the best advice you give me, like sir, aur usse paise lenge sir. Main kaha road pe bhik mango sir. Matlab kaun keh raha hai? Main kaha wo chhod ke chali jayegi. और आप फिर दोस्तों को फोन करना रात 12 बजे, यार मेरा तो कोई है ही नहीं, कैसे होगा? जब लोग थे तो सलाह देते थे, तो तुमने बोला चुप हो जाओ, चले गए. सिंपल एज दैट. गेटिंग माय पॉइंट? सो वन इज चार्ट बेस्ड प्रिंसिपल. एफ्लिक्टेड 9th लॉर्ड, एफ्लिक्टेड 9th हाउस, मेलिफिक्स इन द 12th हाउस, मोर देन थ्री मेलिफिक्स इन द केंद्रास, थ्री मेजर कॉम्बिनेशन. पर्सन डजंट बिलीव इन एस्ट्रोलॉजी, इफ इवन इफ ही इज एन एस्ट्रोलॉजर, he will be like, everything is predestined, we cannot change it. Whatever happens will happen. Okay. Other thing is Vinash Kale Viprit Buddhi, bad dasha, bad transit, combust planet, etc. Oi hai vahi jo Ram rachi rakha. These are the things. These are the two conditions. Acha, there is one particular combination for following astrology. Raj Yogas. When you have good Raj Yogas, you are supposed to give heed to every good advice. Bad dasha, antar dasha. Someone is telling you to invest money, you don't. After some time, money stop coming. You are worried. Normal dasha, antar dasha, or only dhan yoga. Money starts coming, someone tell you to invest, you don't invest, but money keeps on coming. Raj yoga. Money comes, someone tell you to invest in one property, you purchase in two properties. Double the return after 10 years, right? So that is also the configuration. not following astrology is one thing. Hardcore astrology follower, good Rajyogas in the chart. I'll show you. Any chart with good Rajyogas you see, you tell that person that you follow astrology, numerology, palmistry, or a particular guru by your complete heart, he will always say yes. That's why the ninth house is guru. Because that's why fortune, that's where from fortune will come. Getting my point? That's why 10th house is success in life. 10th house is the sky. Astrology is the study of sky. Right? These are a few of the things, right?